All right, let's get into this message. All right, what is CERN? Man, CERN, I don't even know how to even get into this message. There's so much to it. It's so much to it, I don't even know how to get in it, but I'm gonna try. Now, what is CERN? Now, I'm gonna break this down as easy as I can possibly make it so you'll understand it. There is a facility over in Switzerland. It's a 17-mile underground circle that they put 300 feet underground, and it's 17 miles wide. What they are doing is they are taking matter, or you learned this in school where you are. You know what an atom is. You know matter. You know the building blocks, the smallest particle, matter, right? They're taking that, and they're shooting it at the speed of light through this 17-mile circle, which is a magnetic field that, and they're shooting it as fast as they can get it, because they're trying to go. They're trying to go through another dimension. They've already said what they're trying to do. Now, the particles that they're shooting create something. And I'm going to get into this and show you how all of this is working. Now, this is the most dangerous thing that there is. This is the revelation. This is what the book of Revelations was talking about. They are going to have this thing is going to be in full power by September this year. They've already started up. It takes months to get it at full speed. They had it started 2 years ago, but it wasn't enough power, so they doubled the power. And they started it up this time. And what it does, they find in other things that it does. Now, they say they don't know what's going to happen. That's what they say. I don't believe that. But they say that something is going to bend time and space. Now, you've been watching this through movies all this time. You've been watching this. I told y'all that they are putting this stuff in the movies because they're conditioning you for it. Because they're conditioning you for what's coming. You got to realize all the movies is about fighting against this alien thing or whatever's coming. They're getting you ready to fight against something that's coming. Y'all there? Now, so what they're doing is with this over in Switzerland is there's now Stephen Hawking, which is the top physicist. You know that little crippled dude in the wheelchair, but he's a physicist. He can't even talk, but he's must got some type of good mind. He told him, don't do it. He said, they are getting ready to open the gates of hell. He said, don't. He said, it's the scariest thing he's ever seen. And you got to realize this guy's an atheist. But he knows, don't do this. Because he knows that they're trying to open space. Now, every movie, especially the latest superhero movies, is telling you the same thing. All the Transformer movie was about opening a portal to get stuff, really trying to bend space to make it easier for whatever coming from one dimension to the next. It's just a window. It's an opening. You remember a movie called Stargate? It was just an opening from one place in space to another. You got what I'm saying? Time travel. You can say all of that, but it's basically just portals. Say portals. Now, I taught this a while back in a message called The Portals of Darkness. And I was saying stuff that I didn't even research. I didn't even know. I was saying that by the spirit. And I was so shocked how accurate I was when I researched it now. That what I was talking about was exactly what they're doing. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? So, now, when they take these particles and shoot them at the speed of light, when it gets to full capacity, it's going to release something called antimatter. Say antimatter. So we got matter and antimatter. Now, matter is good matter. That's good stuff. That's what we are. That's what you can see. But there's also, but antimatter is the opposite. It's like darkness and light. Matter would be light, and antimatter would be darkness. Amen. This machine is allowing them to collect antimatter or darkness. Now, they say that the antimatter that they get, what they're collecting, comes from the place on the other side of that dimension. Right? Come on, y'all stay with me now. I told you this is going to be scientific a little bit. Now, they have found what they call the wall. The wall they have found by this machine they got, that there is a wall that they know that is holding back antimatter or darkness. They know it. Now, what they're doing this time is trying to find the building blocks of that wall so they can dismantle it, so they can let whatever's being held back come through. That's why they're saying they don't know what might come through. But now that they done started this machine up, they're starting to hear demons and all types of stuff now because they're getting close to this. Come on, y'all. Now I'm going to show y'all how you watching this. Now, I know most of y'all saw the movie The Avengers, you know, the movie with the Marvel movie with the Hulk and, then Captain America and all them. The last one. Now, y'all know, not the Ultron, the one before that, because I didn't see the last one. I didn't see the Ultron. I saw the one before that. Remember in that movie how there was a, listen now, y'all, no. I gotta say this to get you to understand, because these concepts are very difficult to understand if we talk about physics. So we're going to talk in terms of what we understand. Since most of y'all seen the movie, you would understand what I'm going to tell you. Now, you know in this movie, the guy called Loki, which was a god, came and he was looking for this power, this energy source. It was a blue energy source called the Tesseract. This Tesseract had enough power that if they would, work with it, they could open a portal. Remember, that was what the goal was, to open a portal. Because when they opened the portal, on the other side of the portal, there was like demons waiting to come through. Do y'all remember that movie? Every movie, sci-fi movie, has been saying the same thing all the way back since Star Trek. They're trying to open something. Everything that we have learned is about opening up a portal. And I'm going to make it personal, but first I got to give you the overall understanding. You got what I'm saying? Now, so over there in Switzerland, that 17-mile circle is a big portal that once it gets to full capacity, something's going to open. Now, let me tell you a little bit about this, what they're collecting. They had collected this antimatter, and it takes a long time to collect a little bit, like a gram of it. It takes a long time. But they took and hid that antimatter in a college years ago. And in this college, people started having weird dreams and getting possessed and all kinds of bad stuff happened. Just where they stored it. Because the antimatter, they say, when it comes in connection with you, it will begin to pull the darkness or magnify the darkness in you. See, because you are made up, listen, you are made up of matter. You are also made up of antimatter. Let it sink in. You are made, remember Jesus said, if the light in you be darkness, how great the darkness. You are made up of matter and antimatter. Throughout the course of your life, if you never accept the light, then you will remain and grow in antimatter or darkness. So they're capturing evil. Which when that evil gets close to you, it's like a magnet. It magnifies the evil in you. Let it sink in. Please let it sink in. This is what they over capturing in this machine. So when they released this, and they said this, it's going to change people into literal demons. The only thing that's going to stop it is what God has put her to restrain. There's only one thing restraining Satan from totally destroying you. I mean, totally taking your mind and everything away. It's just, listen, right now, for us that believe, it's the Holy Spirit. But there's also and I'm going to show y'all in the Bible where this exists. There's also, they found out there is a restrainer, a wall. They call it a veil. That is literally holding back. Listen, now listen to what I'm saying. Matter, smallest building block, matter, right, is stable. In other words, it doesn't catch on fire. You have to catch it on fire in order for it to burn. But they say antimatter is already on fire. It has to be contained because it's already burning. That's why they need that big facility to hold it. They said if a little bit of this stuff get out, it could be like 40 nuclear bombs. So when you start looking at this stuff going on in Revelation, what was happening to these places, now you see why these earthquakes was going on. Because y'all hear me saying? Now, so are y'all staying with me so far? So this is what they're doing over there. And what they're saying, and then what they're saying they're doing is that they are trying to find out how it was at the Big Bang. That's what they said they're doing. And so that's what they're saying. They're trying to reproduce the conditions to find out what happened, what elements came together to give them that Big Bang, which we know that's just a lie. So now I'm going to go deep. You ready? I'm going to go deep. Y'all ready? Come on now. You got to keep your, get your spiritual mind out here. Now, so they're looking for the God particle. Now listen, this is the way I best describe it. Let's say you came into a you was driving and you drove up on a city. City was full of houses and it was all buildings there and people could live there and everything. And you wanted to find out how they were built, right? So you start trying to break it down and thinking, but you instead of you finding nails, you find everything's put together by glue. So you start trying to dissect it to get down to find out what is the glue made out of. That's what they're doing. Everything is being held together by something. They know it. We are here being held together, but they want to find out what is holding it together. Right? So they want to mess with the glue. So they trying to, so these particles, they're trying to get to the finest particle to find out what everything is built from. That's why they call it the God particle. Yeah, does this make sense? Now, we know in the Bible that the Bible says he upholds all things by the word of his power. Everything that's into being is being held together by God's word. So when they get all the way, now listen, I'm going to show you what they're doing, and it's going to blow your mind. When they get all the way down to the finite understanding, they're going to find, what God is using to hold it all together. That's why the war between Satan and Christ wouldn't be a war unless Satan had a real weapon. So what is the real weapon? It is what they're going to try to use, what God is using, which is just the... Now, when we say his word, what is that? What is his word? What is this? It's his power. They're going to find out what it is and weaponize it. They're going to weaponize it. This is the reason why they're going to be ready to fight against the Lamb when he comes. Are y'all ready? Because when you get down to the finite, it's all being held together by his word. But that's what they found out. The scientists are saying they found out what they're not calling him the God of the Bible, but they understand there is a creator. And they found, now what they have found is this creator has built a wall of separation so that those dimensions that are chaotic, they said those dimensions are chaotic. It's chaos, just like hell. And we are literally being protected by a veil that God put around us, but man is going to have to. Now, what does these movies keep telling you? In that movie, The Transformers, Megatron got the humans to build him a body. He's thinking that man is getting knowledge to open the portal for him. To do what? To let the fallen angels come through. So man think he's wise, and they sitting there building our own destruction. Come on, please tell me y'all can handle what I'm saying. Is this too much? Come on, get your pure mind out. I'm trying to show you what's going on and what they're doing and what the effects are going to be once they get this thing up to full power. All right, now, get your word. Let me give you some scripture. Get your word out. Come on, bro. 2 Thessalonians chapter, chapter 2. That should be chapter 2. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. Now I'm going to show you this so you can understand it. Now I just happened to copy this out of the NET Bible. It was an accident. I wasn't paying attention to what I was copying down. But this is the Bible. Please don't go into no versions. Don't. Do I have to get the King James up? Because Negroes, you know how we do, you know. I believe the Bible. Trust me. Are y'all there? But I like how this is reading, so I'm going to read it out of this. Amen. Y'all ready? Are you there? 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 1. It says, now regarding the arrival of our Lord Jesus Christ and our being gathered to be with him, we ask you, brothers and sisters, not to be easily shaken from your composure or disturbed by any kind of spirit or message or letter allegedly from us to affect that day of the Lord is into the effect that the day of the Lord is already here. This is what we're dealing with now. People just don't know. It's all kind of stuff going on. You better know what you believe. Verse 3, let no one deceive you in any way, for that day will not arrive until the rebellion. Say the rebellion. The rebellion comes and the man of lawlessness is revealed, the son of destruction. The man of lawlessness, son of destruction. Y'all got that? Now, let me blow your mind. You ready? This pope, this wicked, wicked pope, has just came out and said that Jesus Christ is not the truth. The pope. He also said, now I'm going to blow your mind, that we're waiting to reveal aliens as angels. Now, to show y'all how messed up this is, the Vatican has a telescope in America, the most powerful one in the world. And they say they have seen something coming. The Vatican. This is what the world is getting ready for. They say they see something that's coming, and they're getting ready for it. And they're ready to, the Pope said, we're ready to reveal the Messiah. This is what's happening while we arguing over doctrine. They sitting there saying, we're ready to, that's why they're trying to tell you that any church, all churches must come back under the Vatican or the Roman Catholic Church. That's why they're telling you that. Because the Pope is, of course, this is Antichrist. I talked for years that that was a false prophet. He's going to give his power to the beast. The beast is coming. Now, why do y'all think that the Catholic Church put out the lie of the rapture? Yeah, it's a lie. I'm going to show y'all why they did this. Y'all ready? Because they have a false Christ coming. That people are going to think that's the Christ. And they said his name may be Sanada, that Hindu God that's supposed to, you know, that even the image of Christ ain't even Christ. But I mean, it's really hard to even deal with that part. But that's who they, see, that's why they got that fake image of Jesus in your mind, because that's what he's going to look like. And people, oh, that's Jesus with this beard and this little gay look. You're going to think that's him. That's why God was crafty in Revelation to say this is what he looked like. This is what he looked like. So when he come, if he ain't got this afro and this dark and this bronze skin, then you know we ain't talking about. Y'all got what I'm saying? Now, so the Pope, you can look this up. This ain't even know. It's so funny how the devil is putting it right in our face now, because he know we too dumb down to even look at it. So they saying they're waiting for this. Now, you know, they've been talking about this planet that they've been seeing coming for years. And you can actually see it now. If you catch it on some days or some mornings, you can actually see this planet. So they know it's coming. Now, our governments have dumbed it down. And Russia has threatened Obama. They told Obama, if you don't tell these, if y'all don't say that there's a planet of these beings are coming, we're going to tell it. Our government has been knowing this. They're getting the earth prepared for this. Y'all, come on. Can I go? Now, ain't it funny how our education system turned us off of anything supernatural, spiritual? But that's exactly where science is. Now science is in the spiritual and supernatural. Are y'all there? Okay, let me keep going. Come on, Tim. Okay, let no one see me, for that day will not arrive until the rebellion comes. The rebellion's coming. This is what the Pope is saying is coming. Now, he says, and the man of lawlessness, the beast, is going to be revealed, the son of destruction. Now, what's the name of the son of destruction? It's a name for him in the Bible. It's Apollyon, the destroyer, which just by, just to give you some information, the place where CERN is, it's called Apollyon. Yeah, it's called, it's, and I'll show you. I'll get a little deep into that. Okay, now, he opposes and exalts himself above every so-called god or object of worship, and as a result, he himself takes his seat in God's temple, displaying himself as God. Surely you recall that I used to tell you these things while I was still with you. And so you know what holds him back so that he will be revealed in his own time. Read it out of King James. We got King James. Read it. Just read it, somebody. The sixth verse. Read it loud. Okay, now what is he saying? He's saying that he's saying this thing could possibly be seen, but there's something holding it back. So he can't come. Even though the man of sin, this Antichrist, this beast, Satan wants to come into our realm, into this natural realm, something's restraining him from coming. So these people over in Switzerland with this CERN machine are taking apart the restraint that God put in place to hold back that dark dimension. I don't know if y'all even be listening to what I be saying sometimes. So they done found out that I'm telling you, ain't this something? Because they meddling with stuff, it ain't that they meddling. They don't want to, Bible said, because they wouldn't retain God in their knowledge, then they became stupid fools. So they fools. They doing foolish stuff because they don't want to believe in the God of the Bible. So they go looking for something else. And Satan is promising them knowledge and eternal life. Build this for me. Come on, put this together. And that's why we have an explosion of knowledge, because science went from real science to the occult. See, that's why everything we have built now is occultish. Because Satan promises them knowledge. And they get rich, of course, and get prestige and honor from the knowledge, but they just keep building him a world. They're building for him. They may not know they're building for him, but that's what they're doing. Now, so put it back up there. So you know that what holds him back so that he will be revealed in his own time, for the power of lawlessness, for the hidden power. Listen to me. You gotta understand these scriptures. The hidden power, I mean what you can't see. It's already working. This dark side is already working. Because I told you, what are they coming back to him? What are they collecting over there with that machine? Darkness, antimatter. There's matter. Come on, I have to get y'all with this. It's the point of my thesis, and if I don't get y'all to get this, you'll be lost. They are collecting matter. They actually collecting the dark side of matter, the antimatter. Okay, this what they call chaotic and unstable. Yeah. It is darkness. They are collecting darkness. Do y'all hear what I'm trying to tell y'all? God put us in a realm of light. This realm, this earth realm. This, I'm not saying earth, I'm saying dimension. What we can see, this three dimension is a realm of light. It's a realm of goodness. Even if you don't know God, there's goodness here. You sense goodness. You can feel love. That realm without the veil, it's chaotic, it's evil, totally demonic. It is hell. That's why the Bible calls it the bottomless pit, the abyss. It's not a hole in the ground, it's a dimension that's open. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? It is chaotic. I will tell y'all what it is better. The Bible says in the Genesis 1:1 that what happened was in Genesis was the earth was without form and void. That word void in the Hebrew meant chaos. Let it sink in. Which means the realm that God is withholding was once over the whole world. So when he said, let there be light, he started dividing, putting the veils, block them. And he said, put the earth here, sky here, go here. He was blocking the, oh. But man is tampering with what is restraining darkness. And just so happens, listen now, scientists have figured out, these physicists know that I told y'all before that antimatter, darkness, is in each one of us. Now, this is crazy. This is what happened to Adam. He was a creature of light. When he sinned, darkness came in him. Darkness came into the flesh of man. You got what I'm saying? After that, every man was born with automatic. That's why you ain't got to teach us to sin. We will sin because it's in us to sin. You got what I'm saying? The problem is that, well, not the problem, but the goal of life. Man, I'm giving y'all some stuff here. Let me see. Listen, the goal of life is for you to meet the light, or you will die in your darkness. Which means your darkness. Now listen to me. Oh God help me. That scientists, that these physicists have said that, remember, that what they are collecting, this antimatter, this darkness, is still connected to whatever's on the other side. And they said, and this one Christian scientist said that demons are attracted to antimatter or darkness. Come on, let it sink in. So if a person, listen, lives their life and never runs into the light and start to be renewed and regenerated by the light of Christ, the darkness in them will grow. This is why people that don't know Christ and get older, they hard, they just can't believe, because their darkness has grown. And the reason why this is so dangerous and understanding what the Antichrist is going to do is they're collecting this antimatter and they're going to use it in the tribulation, that when a person does not have the light in them, they will use it against you and increase your darkness. Think about what I'm going to tell you. Every dark thought, desire, deed in you will be magnified. Because the scientists have said that when they take this antimatter and they bring it and it gets close to anybody, it begins to bring darkness out of people. People start getting hallucination and depth and all kinds of stuff start happening in their mind, and they start seeing spirits and stuff. This is what these people were playing with. And we thought this is science. No, this is the occult. This is spiritual. Can y'all handle what I'm saying? Hold on, Tim. Let me show you. Let me show you. Oh, Lord. I messed with my. Oh, I got it. Put that up right, Tim. Now, this is the CERN logo. Over in this is what the logo. If you notice what it is, it's three sixes, which is the mark of the beast. The beast being a polyon, comes out of the bottomless pit. Are y'all there? Take me down, Tim. I put me up there. This is the god of Shiva in front of the building of CERN. This is the, now this god of Shiva is doing a dance of death and life and creation around a portal. Now, if I can break this down spiritually, finitely for you. This dance is an occultic dance that is designed to bring, okay, when Satanists want to operate, they know they need demons. That's why they draw circles, because they got to draw a portal, a star, a portal, a place for the spirit to come through. Now, depending upon the ritual, they need blood. They need, because the Bible says, listen, the power is in the blood. That's why Satanists need sacrifices, because they know that the blood can breathe. Listen to me now, I'm deep now. Can y'all handle this? The blood is spiritual and natural. It can cross both realms. the more the blood, that's why the Bible says when blood is spilt, the ground is cursed. Why? Because when blood is, innocent blood is shed, it's a place demons can inhabit. So when you go, if you go in there, if you ever seen witch doctors, anybody who operates in that stuff, it's always chicken blood all around. Why? Because that's what they're using. They got to give the demons a portal to come through. Now listen, you, and when if you're a witch or you into witchcraft, you the chance, you are the portal. They come, because remember, you are, got the darkness in you. But you need to do the ritual to give them the power to come through you. Now, Satan can't do a lot just coming through one individual here, one individual there. That's why they build a machine. So he can come through. Is this too much? Let me keep going. Shiva, this Hindu god. They got that. This is her symbol, because what this god is doing is what they're doing. They're doing it scientifically, what the occult has been doing for centuries. See, science is the occult now. So when them witches are doing these rituals, what they're doing in the lab is what witches are doing. They're just not doing the rituals that witches are doing, but they're actually dealing with the elements that the witches are doing spiritually. So you can conjure up demons a number of ways. Dance, that's what them ritual dances in Africa are. That's why a lot of the dances they're doing now are ritual dances. A lot of this freaky nay-nay, all that stuff, it's just ritual dances. That's why it makes people look gay when they do it. It's rituals. Because in voodoo, if that's what they do to conjure up Isu, them voodoo demons, they dance, and then they go into a trance, which is what the clubs are modeled after of. You do know when you was in the club and all that, that's what the club really was modeled from. Mesmer knew, they took it from voodoo, that if you get enough people together, change their rhythm with a beat, that you can cause them to transcend. That's what voodoo is. Then what are they transcending from? So demons can come through. They creating a portal. The dance is creating a portal. But that's why once a person gets the dance, you get sexual, you get lustful. Come on, is this too much? Now, is this too... Are y'all understanding what I'm saying? So this Shiva god is doing a dance called destruction, then recreation. Destruction and recreation. This put my picture up right, Tim. The circle is a portal. Now, this is, let me show y'all what CERN is. Take me down, Tim. I put them up there. This is what CERN is. This is 17 miles of like a snake all the way around, which is just the Ouroboros, which is in Freemasonry, but I ain't got time going there. This is what it is. It's a machine, but it's like a long, big 17-mile long snake that they shooting these particles through at the speed of light. Real, real fast, trying to get it go real fast. Now, it even looked like a portal. It's a portal. Now, take me down, Tim. So Shiva's doing this dance, and the goal is destruction first, chaos, then recreation. You got what I'm saying? So what they are doing is destruction. They going to destroy some stuff with this machine. They believe that's where that earthquake came from in Nepal when they started that machine up. They started earthquakes. Anyway, and then the rebirth, which is the fake Messiah. Y'all got what I'm saying? Now, can we keep going? All right. Put me back up, right, Tim. Did I read that? No. Here we go. So that what holds him back, we revealed in his own time, for the hidden power of the lawless is already at work. However, the one who holds him back would do so until he is taken out. Now listen, taken out. Didn't say he was moved or he left. They don't found a way to take it out of the way. They take it out the restrainer. So break it down. Let's go. Can we go further? Amen. Come on. Can we go further? Amen. So it says, put it back up there, Tim. However, the one who holds him back would do so until he's taken out of the way. Okay, so we know that what's restraining is a he. Right? So what is restraining evil? He is a he restraining evil. Now we know him in the person of the Holy Spirit. But y'all not catching how powerful this is. Even sinners right now, he's restraining evil from sinners. So what are they doing? They finding a way. Oh man, I even just. Now there was when I studied this a while back, there was a scientist that said, listen now, I think I told y'all this, that there is an invisible shield around the earth. They can't see it, but they know it's there. They said this shield is holding back stuff, but they can't see it. See, the earth is protected by the power of. So what are they doing? They finding ways to punch holes in the shield. Because God is so good. Listen to how good your God is. That he has put something here for those that even don't love him will still be protected if they don't start messing with Satan's devices and open a hole for themselves. Hey, y'all catching what I'm trying to tell y'all? You start sinning, sinning will create a hole. Didn't I not tell y'all that a while back, the portals of darkness? Sin is a sin attracts antimatter, darkness. It creates a hole, a place, an atmosphere for demons to dwell. That's why you go in some places that this evil's been happening there. I don't feel good. Well, no, why you feel like getting there? Because, man, he got all kinds of portals in here. That's why I never, when I found out haunted house, no, I don't going to haunted house. I'm going nowhere where they celebrating, conjurating, nothing. Going some people's out there, oh man, what's wrong? What's going on? It's like the chaos is in there. They got something going on. Are y'all there? Okay. Lord help me get done. Lord, look at what time it is. Come on. Okay, so see, he is taken out of the way. He taken out of the way. They found what has built the wall, the veil. They call it the veil. Come on, y'all. They call it in the veil. They found what is. They found the particles that make up the wall. And this time they started up the machine. The goal is to deconstruct the actual veil that's restraining darkness. Y'all should, oh man, I don't know. I don't know if y'all even, you ain't gonna hear this teaching nowhere. All right, come on, Tim. And the lawless, then the lawless one will be revealed. Well, the lawless one would be revealed if the veil was moved. Because as you're talking about the dimension, you're talking about from here to here. But it's a veil there that's keeping him from doing what he wanted to do and keeping us from being affected as much by him. But once the veil is removed, then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord will destroy. Now this is what's going to be the time clock when they punch through this. That's when Christ said, "Up, let's roll." Now we go. Why? Because they have assaulted the Holy Spirit now. Time to roll. He going to come destroy them then. Come on. Let me show y'all how they put that in the movie. Can y'all? You remember in the movie, The Avengers, when Thor was telling, Captain America that, because y'all mess with this energy source, this tesseract, the other dimensions see that Earth is ready for another level of warfare. See, because y'all open this portal, that's all I'm teaching. And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord will destroy with the breath of his mouth. I told y'all, why is this the breath of his mouth? Because we're no longer talking about natural beings. Ain't that going to be powerful? Man, the breath of his mouth. And wipe out and wipe out by the manifestation of his arrival. So what are we talking about here? Light. We talking about light. Because what's what we talking about? They don't open darkness. Light. That's how powerful our God is. That just when he show up, the brightness is going to burn up everything. All right. That's why you're going to need a glorified body. Because anything that ain't protected by light will be destroyed, will be burned up. Come on, let's go. Thank you, bro. Okay. The arrival of the lawless one will be by the Satan's working with all kinds of miracles, signs and wonders, signs and false wonders, and with every kind of evil deception directed against those who are, wait. Not those who are saved. This is against people who are already lost. Why can't he direct it against us? See, all kinds of evil deception, that's the warfare. What is the lying wonders for? To fool you, to deceive you. But it ain't directed against us, but it's directed against those who are already perishing. Why can't it be directed against us? Because the light in us will tell us this ain't God, that ain't God. You ought to, I'm telling y'all, you ought to be glad you sealed with the Spirit of God. Why? Because they found no place in their hearts for the truth so as to be saved. Man, that's a scary thought. They didn't make no place. There was no place found in their heart for the truth. Consequently, God will send them strong delusion or deluding influence so that they will believe what is false. Now, this lie we've been talking about for a while, but what is the lie? That this thing coming, this beast is God. Bible says he's going to set himself up and call himself God. The world's going to think he's God. That's the lie. But he's going to give them strong delusion because the truth wasn't in them anyway to believe the lie. Come on, Tim. And so all of them who have not believed the truth but delighted in evil will be condemned. But we ought to thank God always for you, brothers and sisters, loved by the Lord, because God chose you from the beginning for salvation through sanctification, listen, by the Spirit and in faith and in truth. That's why I told you the Spirit is going to be everything. Those with the Spirit of light or Spirit of God in them, they won't be deceived. Why do you think they try and kill you? They want you gone. They ain't trying to deceive us. They want us gone. Because we're walking around with this light, this truth. That's why when you show up somewhere, if you really walk in the light, they just get mad at you just because you in truth. You ain't said nothing about their lifestyle. You just walking into the truth. Come on. He called you to this salvation through our gospel so that you may possess the glory of our Lord Jesus, the glory, the light of our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, now go to Revelation 9. Come on, real quick, let me get done. Revelation chapter 9. Now do you see what Satan is doing? Please tell me you can understand what Satan is doing. Why are they using this, what this whole end time, how people who was trying to decipher the book of Revelations, that's why they got it so wrong 50 years ago, because they don't even understand the new technology is what Daniel said needed to be increased. When men shall, listen, go to and fro. He's talking about internet stuff. Travel, worldwide travel, being able to go from, you can go on the internet and go from here to China like that. The internet is actually the net, the way of the snare that Satan is actually using to connect the world anyway. But we ain't going to get into that. But knowledge has to be increased. So these guys were trying to decipher prophecies without knowing what is the internet. 50 years ago, they didn't know what it was. That's why all them books were so wrong. Left Behind and all this stuff is wrong. Because they needed technology. Now we realizing that what John was seeing, remember they was trying to symbolically say it was that. Now you realize, no, that's what it was. Them beasts come, demons coming out of the bottomless pit, them scorpion heads, they symbolize that. So that'll be a tank. No, that's going to be a scorpion head But see, we didn't know that because we were thinking about in our own natural time, and all them brothers wrote them books to deceive people. Really, they was wrong. That's why the Bible says, be careful. Don't be messing with that book of Revelation. Don't take nothing away from it. Don't add nothing to it. Because really, in the time of the end, it's be revealed. That's why it's being revealed. That's why everything is falling out now. All the truth is coming out. That's why Satan is just going crazy, because all the truth is coming out. I mean, he's using so much distraction. He's using everything he can to stop people from just, come on, let's go. Revelation 9. You got that, Tim? Verse 1. You ready? This is what's happening when they open this seal. Open this portal. And you do know there's more than one CERN. They got about 14 of these machines in the world. I forgot to tell y'all that. So think about when the Bible says this seal was open, the first seal was open, the second seal was open, the third seal was open. Think about what it's talking about. That should have blew your mind right there. As a matter of fact, it's not 14. I think it's 7. I think it's 7 of them. They got 3. I think they said they got 3 here. They're not as big, though, as that biggest one. But they got them. They got the 3 of them here. So they opening seals. Come on, y'all. Think about what we're saying here. Then the fifth angel blew his trumpet, and I saw a star that had fallen from the sky to earth. And he, a star falling to the earth's sky, and he was given a key. What was he given a key? The key was for the shaft. Listen to the language of the bottomless pit. The key was to the open. It was a key he had to open a pit. Now, remember I told y'all the Pope said something's coming. They seen it. Now, you can just look this up yourself. They know it's coming. The world is, they ain't telling you because you're panicked. The superpowers are getting ready for this. They know it's coming. Whatever's coming is what's going to be the one that's going to open this thing up. Whatever they got coming is what's going to open this thing. Now, listen. He opened the shaft of the abyss. Smoke rose out of it like a giant furnace. The sun and the earth were darkened with the smoke from the shaft. And out of the smoke came locusts onto the earth, and they were given power like scorpions of the earth. Now, these demons is coming through this portal. Yeah. Right. See, we used to think they was biological. We know, come on, biological weapons. That's what we asked. But these are spirits that have found a way to cross over through man meddling. They were told not to damage the green grass. Ain't that something? Listen to what is leading the world right now. What organization really leading the world? EPA, Environmental Protecting Agency. They'll kill you over a tree. See, don't touch the grass. Don't mess up the grass. Kill the people. See, because they want the earth to go back to the utopia. That's why they want billions of people to die. So they think the earth going to go back to this utopia, and only 500,000 people is what they said will be here. So that's a lot of killing. They were told not to damage the grass or the earth or any green plant, but only the people who did not have the seal of God on their forehead. So there are those that have a seal of God. Amen. Amen. Ain't that something? You think living for God is going to be a choice, boy? You're going to want to live for God during this time. You see these scorpions flying. Come on. Come on, Tim. The locusts were not given permission to kill them, but only to torture them for 5 months, and their torture was like that of a scorpion when it stings a person. In those days, people will seek death, but will not be able to find it. Didn't I tell y'all that Google said in the year, 2025 or something, they're going to find out how to live forever? They already found the immortal gene. Satan's promises forever eternal life. So I believe it's going to be a regeneration thing. I really believe that. You know how they cut a tail off a lizard and grow back? I believe it's going to be something like that where you can't die. You ain't going to be able to die. And it says, but death is going to flee. They will long to die, but death will flee from them. Ain't that powerful? People going to take the mark of the beast because of this promise. Come on, you can live forever. Come on, live forever. Just take your smart and let us change your DNA. We're going to have to, you know, we're going to change you. I'm going to fill you full of this antimatter is what we're going to do. Change you into a whole different being. That's why there's no redemption after you accept the mark, because you no longer going to even be a human. You ain't going to be able to be redeemed, because you won't be redeemable. You will have been transformed from a human into whatever else, probably a devil, some type of devil. Is this too much? Now the locusts look like horses equipped for battle. On their heads was something like crowns similar to gold. Their faces looked like men's faces. They had hair like women and had teeth like lion's teeth. They had breastplates like iron, breastplates, and their sound of their wings was like the noise of many horse-drawn chariots charging into battle. They have tails and stingers like scorpions. Their ability to injure people for 5 months, one sting, 5 months, is in their tails. They have a king over them, the angel of the abyss, whose name in the Hebrew is Abaddon, and in the Greek is Apollyon, which is right where the town of that's what they got their CERN at. Apollyon. Are y'all there? Now, I'm gonna stop here because I'm gonna pick this up. We're gonna go into it deeper when I on my next part. But what I'm telling y'all is, the Bible is true. It is the only book that can tell you what's happening now. Every other book that they use, in Quran, whatever book they got, does not have the accurate prophetic word. That's how you know that we're serving a living God. Because he gave you a word thousands of years ago that is coming to pass with pinpoint accuracy. And I would tell you, man, get to know, get right. I don't even think it's enough to just to say you saved. You're going to have to live this life. I don't know about y'all, but that doesn't sound like a good place. And I don't want my children to have to live and not understand that, look, do you see what's coming? It's coming whether you're ready or not. They said September, this thing is going to be up to full power. And they scared to death about what's going to come, but they still going to do it. Still going to do it. Because they got a covenant with Lucifer. They know who's coming. Them fake Jews know their God is Lucifer. They know who their God is. Them Freemasons got an agreement with Lucifer to bring him, to get him, which they call him the light bearer. That's what they're bringing here, which is the man of sin, which is the beast, the false church, which is the false prophet, which is the Pope, the universal religion of Catholicism, that is, the Pope said every religion must come under the Catholic Church. So that's why the Catholic Church is the false prophet. That's going to do what? Point. The Pope is right now pointing to what's coming, pointing to the beast. Then they're going to give their power to the beast. Then they're going to establish his image, and you're going to have to bow down and worship him, or off with your head. You're going to take the mark, off with your head. So I just believe God is going to try those that are his. That's why I try to tell y'all. See, y'all waiting for the rapture, but them people over there that's getting their head cut off now, what, they raptured? It's really narcissistic of us. You know, in America, we are narcissists. We really think we're so great that God's waiting on us. What about them people? Why ain't he rapturing them people? They getting their head cut off now. Where they raptured? They said before the bad tribulation come, ain't that what we've been told all our life? That you're supposed to be called away? Where is it? They said these locusts, these scorpions are going to sting folks, but not the ones that sealed. What, shouldn't they be gone? The ones with the seal, why they here? Think about it. If they're supposed to be raptured, why the people that are saved are going to be here with a seal on their forehead? But I thought the good people before the tribulation, is this not tribulation? Wasn't they supposed to be taken? Well, why are they standing here with a seal on their forehead? Still here. Being protected from the locusts. Because God's people are going to be proved. This is proven time. This is Jacob's trouble. He's going to prove you. Ain't going to be no going to heaven just getting on a little rowboat. You're going to have to prove that you really, 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 really believe this Christ. That's why the Holy Spirit, y'all, listen, y'all, I'm done. It's so precious. I can't tell y'all enough. I don't know. Ain't no way I could have lasted this long. The Holy Spirit is so precious. Y'all don't even know how powerful it is to be filled with what's restraining evil. You are filled with it. That evil, even the evil in you, can't overcome you. Greater is He that is in you. And this is the reason why we live holy. Because sin stores darkness. Antimatter. That's a scientific understanding of sin. If you want to know what happens when you sin, darkness comes. And it stores darkness. The more people sin, the more darkness is there, the more demons can operate. So when we telling you don't sin, that's why homosexuality is such a strong sin, because it brings a stronger concentration of darkness. That's why you're trying to make everybody gay, because it's totally against God. Y'all understand what I'm saying? Now listen, y'all, I'm done. Scientists, physicists have figured out what church folks won't even believe. Physicists done figured this out. We talking about good and evil, matter, antimatter, light and darkness. Same thing Bible talking about. But they believe, they know it's there and we don't. So we believe we can go out and live in darkness. And it don't affect us. Yet they know when darkness is around you, it affects you. So when we say live right, it ain't for no plaque, no award. It's to keep the darkness away from you. But those of us that are sealed with the Holy Spirit, this is what Satan hates. You can be in the midst, if you seal with the Holy Spirit, you're going to be in the midst of the greatest darkness. If you start praying, light will start overcoming darkness. Light overcomes darkness. That's why he distracts you to pray. He keeps spirit-filled Christians from praying. Because he know light in them will overcome darkness. So we watching TV and we listen to music. And last thing you can do, we can get everybody to do something in church. But what's the smallest meeting? Prayer. Smallest meeting is prayer. People come for everything else, any festivities, have any, they'll be, but prayer, they won't come. Because Satan knows that's where the real power is. And this is what those fake Jews are doing with the Kabbalah. They call what you have, they call the Holy Spirit in you the spark. They know you got it. And they say that they're trying, that's why they're trying to say that they think when we die, the spark in us goes back to the Shekinah, to their God. That's why they want to kill you, to get your spark. I'm just telling you what they believe. That's what the Kabbalah is. And you walking around with the power of the universe in you, and you won't build up your most holy faith. Like Paul said, praying in the Spirit. This is the reason why, listen, when you feel with the Spirit, you can be, your mind, it could be so bad. But when you start praying, man, all of a sudden, peace, it's light. It's overcoming darkness. The good matter is overcoming the antimatter. Spirit-filled Christians are the only ones that can do it. Everybody else has to rely on the restrainer that everybody is restrained by. Stand on your feet. Why y'all think we say get filled with the Spirit? This ain't for no walk around talking in tongues. This is how you build up power. I thank the Lord every time I think about it. I don't even understand. I be thinking like, Lord, every time I think about when He filled me with, that is the greatest thing ever happened in my life. All the trouble I've ever been in, man, when I just start praying, I mean, He really is the comforter. So thank the Lord for that. Seek for your children to be filled. Talk to them about it. Ain't no way we could live this life with all this evil pressing in on us. The darkness is in you. pressing in against you. The Bible said it. The flesh warred against the spirit. The darkness is in your flesh. That's why the flesh goes back to this darkness. That's why when you sin with your flesh, it builds up antimatter, darkness. Do you see what I'm saying? And that starts to war against your spirit. So when you feed your spirit the word and you fast and you pray, your spirit gets bigger, it gets stronger. Why? Because there's more light. That's the time you start seeing revelation, you're hearing God, because you're full of light. But when you don't, when you are carnal, when you look at everything on TV, all that murder, shooting and robbing and killing and listen to all that worldly music, you feel like you're pressed down. You start trying to pray, you feel like you're talking through a tunnel because you feel like God is so far away. Come on, lift your hands up to the Lord. That's why I believe in more than just saying a sinner's prayer. You need to be filled with the Spirit. I wish I could say I had the power in myself to stop doing some of the things that I was into. Man, I found out walking with God, I had less power than I thought I had. I had no power at all. When Satan really, really attacked me, even when I was saved, I realized I ain't got no power in myself. That really is true. There's really no good thing that dwells in us. All that will have to happen is Satan to concentrate on you and show you. Just concentrate an attack on you where he hits you all sides when the enemy come in like a flood. And you'll realize some things. You'll be thinking about stuff you didn't think you ever do. And I went through some stuff in my life that only the Holy Spirit kept me. Hallelujah. Come on, son. Hallelujah. And all I'm here to do is tell you, it's coming. And you're going to have to be ready. And this ain't no movie where you watch 2 hours of superheroism and it's over. This is going to be life. What you see in the movie going to be actually going to look out the window and you're going to see that. And you're going to have to at that time know, what do I really believe? What do I really, really believe? The Bible is the truth, man. Now, I know it sounds cliche-ish, but y'all don't know how real I'm saying that this morning. It is the truth. Every time I think something is outside of the word, it's not. It is the truth. Come on, lift your hands up, play something for fire. Hallelujah. We're going to pray this morning. I'm not giving no altar call. I want you to marinate. Marinate on that word. Think about, are you really ready? Because I think we're making salvation too simple. I really believe that. We're telling you to say a prayer and don't even know if that prayer is in your heart or not. I think we need to really examine. The Bible said, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. We need to really know. You need to know if that's really in your heart. You got to start asking yourself, do I want to be heard? Am I ready to really, really see what's coming? Could I stand up for Christ in this last and evil day? Do I have all of God? Does God have all of me? You got to examine yourself this morning. The Bible says, examine yourself, see whether or not you be in the faith. And I don't know about you, but this is the last, this is no time to play church. I want to be right and real with God. And I thank him that he didn't leave me when I was in a mess and acting a fool. But he restored me so I could be a part of this last day army he's building. You ought to thank God that he caught you before you went out and really lost it all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I don't know about you, but Lord, I repent. Father, I repent. I say it as a pastor. Any evil in me, any darkness, any antimatter I have built up, Lord, remove it. Fill me full of light. Fill me full of light. Any agreement I have with the devil, Lord, break it. Any hidden sin, Lord, reveal it to me. Reveal it to me. Let me be quick to repent. Let me be quick to repent. Hallelujah. Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord, not just to say a prayer, but to live a life. Not just to say it with our mouth, but to live it with our life. We live it. We say, come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Have your way in this wicked earth. For this is not my home. I don't care if I get the best mansion. Come, Lord Jesus, anyway. This is not my dwelling place. Hallelujah. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Come on, tell him, ask him to fill you up. Fill me up, God. Just fill me up, God. Come on, fill us with your spirit, Lord, till we run over. Fill me up, God. Till I run over. Till rivers of living water flow out of my belly. Fill me up. Just fill me up, God. Hallelujah. Till I run over and over. Hallelujah. Come on, say, Lord, fill me with your precious spirit till I run over and over and over and over and over. Hallelujah. 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 Let me run over in my home, on my job. Let me run over in my car. Let me run over in my marriage with my children. Let your spirit run over in me. Hallelujah. Just fill me up, God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on, give him a great hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.